Standing in front of you as the new chief executive for KCB Group, having taken over from Martin Oturo Otieno beginning of this year, I would like to thank the board for appointing me in this position. For me, it's a pleasant and yet humbling experience with my team in KCB, knowing the great responsibility of taking your business in the future lies in my hands and those of my entire team in KCB. The group chairman has just spoken about the economic environment. He's spoken about our business last year, 2012, and he highlighted key lessons, achievements, and prospects about our business. I wouldn't spend much time repeating what the group chairman has spoken, but allow me to speak around three items. One is around our vision. The bank's vision remains to become the preferred financial solutions provider in Africa with global reach. And this means being able to provide solutions with innovation across our customers in all the countries that we operate and beyond. Today, we're in six countries in East Africa, contributing passionately in creating wealth and opening possibilities for our citizens, our customers, our shareholders, and stakeholders. Let me speak about last year, our business performance last year. Last year was a difficult year. The bank achieved good progress, achieving a 14% growth in our earnings before tax at 17.2 billion. We had strong growth on interest income, which increased by 28%. We had a strong growth in foreign exchange income. We increased our customer numbers. We increased the fees and commissions. And we had a new entry in Burundi last year. We also continued to invest strongly in our transformation initiatives last year, which will continue in the momentum in the midterm in the history of the journey of the bank. Speaking on our balance sheet grew last year by 11% to reach close to 367 billion Kenya shillings in terms of total assets. In a similar manner, our customer deposits grew by 11% to 288 billion by the end of last year, with a strong growth in corporate customers, small and medium enterprises, in agriculture, microcredit, construction, and various sectors as you see the expansion of the economy. And similarly, our net loans and advances grew by 7% to reach 212 billion, which means that KCB remains the largest bank in terms of balance sheet, the network within the region, number of ATMs, in terms of profitability, and it remains unmatched in its capacity to grow into the future. Allow me to speak a little bit more about the first quarter results. On Wednesday, the group chairman announced the first quarter results for the bank, which was a good performance showing we are continuing with the momentum. The group recorded a decrease of 26% in earnings before tax to 4.3 billion for the same period last year. I am confident that we will improve this momentum to deliver stronger results in this year and beyond. Speaking much more around the next 12 months, what is the oversight in addition to what the group chairman has mentioned? This year is the year of consolidation of our business, leveraging technology, growing our customer numbers, enhancing our service levels to a level of excellence across our branches, growing together with our county governments, and taking advantage of the developed system of government today with investment in mobile banking, agency banking, internet banking, among new products the bank has issued. On product side, we continue to innovate new products for the young people, the youth, our women, and we continue to relaunch new products this year to enhance the growth of your bank.
It is indeed my pleasure to present to you the bank's financial performance for the year 2012. I'm excited as I expect from all of you to be. The results show great performance in all aspects. It also shows a milestone in our positioning for growth in the future. We are indeed shifting our focus to sustainable growth and excellence in coming years. The bank continued on the path of profitability despite challenging economic environment. We all in East Africa suffered from slow economic growth. We also suffered from inflation, We suffered also from high and rising interest rates. We also suffered a volatile exchange rate. But despite all the above, the bank achieved a 14% growth to attain 17.2 billion shillings PBT. This was an excellent performance, and I believe we are all happy about it. Further good news is that in the Nairobi Stock Exchange, where our shares are traded, last year we started at 17 shillings, and last month we were at 43. This is a 120% growth, and it's something to be very happy about.